Hello, my name is Daniel, and today we'll look at the process of scraping with Playwright and how Playwright compares to other tools with similar purposes, such as Puppeteer, Selenium, and Cypress. Let's start. Playwright is a convenient library for automation and testing. It can mimic human interactions such as navigating to URLs, entering text, clicking buttons, extracting text, and others. It can automate Google Chrome, Microsoft Edge using Chromium, and Firefox and Safari using WebKit. In fact, cross-browser web automation is Playwright's strength. The same code can be efficiently executed for all of these browsers. Moreover, Playwright has wrappers for Node.js, Python, Java, and .NET. Importantly, Playwright's documentation is quite extensive. It covers everything from getting started to advanced functions, with detailed descriptions. In this tutorial, we'll be using Python 3.10, but the code will also work in older Python 3 versions as well. If you haven't installed Python yet, you can download and install the latest version from the link provided in the description. Now, let's install Playwright by executing this command. It will download all the necessary Python modules to interact with the Playwright library. Next, we will have to install the web drivers. Go ahead and run the following command. Playwright will download and store the web drivers in the home folder. We're all set. Now, let's test it out. We will write a simple scraper and parse the page content. Playwright supports both synchronous and asynchronous programming. For now, we will only use the asynchronous functionalities to write our script in asynchronous mode. Let's open a text editor and start writing the script. First, we will have to import the async Playwright function from the Playwright library. We then write our asynchronous main function to fetch the page. In the main function, initialize a browser instance. We pass the argument headless as false so that we can see our browser in action. We will also create a page object to open a new tab in the browser. Then use the goto function from the page object to navigate to our desired website. Let's add a timeout of 1 second using the wait_for_timeout function. Next, we'll extract the title element of the page using the query selector. The inner_text function will allow us to extract the text from the title. Let's print it out. Now, close the browser using the close function. Since our main function is asynchronous, we cannot execute it by calling it directly. We will use the run function of the async.io module. Let's test it. We will open a new terminal and run the Python script. It will open up a browser and go to the website. Then it will extract the title text for the website. It worked! As you can see, the script has printed the title text successfully. Now, if we were to discuss proxies and how they interact with Playwright, then it should be noted that Playwright supports proxies right out of the box. Thus, in the next section, we will demonstrate how to integrate Oxylabs' proxies with Playwright. Initially, we just have to add a few lines to the script. Let's open the script again in the text editor. Add 3 new variables at the top, username, password, and proxy_address. You'll need to fill in the username and password variables with the same username and password you used to create a new proxy subuser in the Oxylabs dashboard. For Oxylabs residential proxies, specify the endpoint using pr.oxylabs.io as an address along with 7777 as port. You can also use our dedicated and shared data center proxies by specifying different addresses and endpoints. For more proxy configuration details, check our documentation by following the links in the video description. Now, let's update our browser object to use the new proxy configurations. We will pass a new optional argument, proxy, with a dictionary of the username, password, and server. And that's it! If we execute this script now, it will use our proxy to fetch the website. Notably, if you get any errors, make sure that the credentials are up to date. Also, all the links to the pages mentioned in this tutorial are in the video description below. Now, let's briefly examine how Playwright compares to other tools such as Puppeteer. Both Playwright and Puppeteer are Node.js libraries that were effectively developed by the same team and had rather similar APIs. This results in the choice between Playwright and Puppeteer becoming less pronounced and entirely case-dependent. For example, suppose browser support is a crucial feature for you. In that case, Playwright may be the more attractive option as, unlike Puppeteer, it supports WebKit, which is a key engine for any third-party iOS browser. Future developments is another factor that ought to be considered when picking a relevant tool. Thankfully, in this case, both Playwright and Puppeteer still get active support. Lastly, as mentioned in this section initially, your choice should be case dependent. Thus, before starting any web scraping job, we recommend conducting research, specifically for your project. Also, if we compare Playwright to more tools such as Selenium, the differences become slightly more pronounced. Looking at the history of these tools, Selenium was released in 2004, while Playwright came out as late as 2020. Immediately, you can assume that Playwright was created with current issues in mind, and we can see this more as we inspect the tool's features, like cross-browser testing, where Playwright outdoes Selenium in speed, coverage, accuracy, and the ability to easily achieve these benefits on complex applications. Yet the choice between the two is still not immediately apparent, as Selenium has its benefits too. A significant portion of them can be attributed to the Selenium's age, such as extensive support community, language options, integrations, and popularity. Furthermore, if user consistency among different browsers is your priority, then Selenium remains the top choice. Furthermore, Selenium now has a robust complementary solution called Cypress. It is an end-to-end framework that not only allows testing from the creation to the execution phases, but also provides value by enabling developers to write automated web tests in JavaScript. But how does Cypress compare to Playwright? The end goal of testing processes is similar for both solutions, although there are noteworthy differences between the two. Cypress is more of a package tool, because it generates a folder system to assist tester teams. This results in the testers having to work within the confines of an existing test runner framework. Playwright doesn't do that, thus allowing you to choose your test runner framework, resulting in greater flexibility. Furthermore, Cypress focuses on JavaScript, while Playwright supports a varied selection of languages, such as JavaScript, Java, Python, and .NET. Interestingly, these differences make choosing between Cypress and Playwright somewhat simpler. If the rigid framework and focus on JavaScript doesn't interest you, then Playwright is possibly the more optimal solution. Overall, we hope you found the web scraping tutorial with Playwright useful. Suppose you are considering using a different tool for your web scraping projects. In that case, the comparisons described in the later part of the video should help you see the advantages and disadvantages of each solution. If you have questions, contact us at hello@oxylabs.io or simply leave a comment below. To see more content like this, press the subscribe button as well as like and share this video on your social media. Thank you for tuning in. This was Oxylabs, and we hope to see you again next time.